Welcome to the showcase of the next iteration of Rent GPU on Golem project, this time with JupyterLab package. At first, we will launch the Golem provider with JupyterLab software and pre-installed packages. Basically speaking, we will just run the Jupyter server and connect via Golem network into it. We will list installed Python packages. We will perform simple analysis of the dataset. We will train the predictive model on the Golem provider. And in the end, we will check if the predictive model works properly for our needs. So, without further ado, we will go to the Rent GPU on Golem website. We will choose our provider, which is SD-3060. With GeForce RTX 3060 graphics card installed on it and 13.63 GB of RAM available for the provider. We will click the Start button and choose JupyterLab Virtual Machine. Now, machine is booting up, and when the virtual machine will be ready, we will continue our showcase. Machine is ready, so we will connect via given link. We'll click the link and wait a little bit for a Jupyter server to properly launch our website. Jupyter server is almost ready. Maybe we will refresh the page. Oh, okay. And now we will open the new notebook. Inside the notebook, we'll write pip freeze. And we have listed our available packages. If somebody wants, then you can just look up for the packages. You can just pause the video. I will slowly go through all of them. And that's all of them. We will now import libraries. Libraries are imported. So we will copy our dataset. Our dataset is about iris flowers. We will look at the sepal length of the iris, sepal width, petal length at petal width, and we will try to guess the species of this iris flower. Species can be either setosa, versicolor, or virginica. Now when we have our dataset inside the RAM, we'll create the data frame out of it. We will check the info about our dataset, and we have the information that every single space inside this data frame is non-null, and that's exactly what we need. We will perform simple analysis by looking at the plots of the data inside our dataset. We'll wait a little bit for the graphs. And as we can clearly see, graphs are working as well. So we will now look at our data, and we can see that our data are spread into the clusters pretty well. So what we will try to do, we will try to use support vector machine to create a predictive model for our data set. So at first we will define the training dataset and the testing dataset. For the testing dataset, we will drop the species, and for the inputs for our model, we will drop the species, and for the outputs, we will choose only the species from our dataset. Then we'll split our training datasets into the train and test, and we'll print the head of our X-train. We can see that we have everything beside the species, and everything is also randomized. So now we will define the model. We will fit our training data into the dataset, and this way we will train it. It is already done. We'll create the predictions, and we will print the confusion matrix. As we can clearly see, almost everything is classified correctly, beside one instance of the data. So we will print the report of our classification, and we can see that there is a room for improvement. So we will redefine our model with a different kernel. And we will click enter. We will fit our data into the model, and again, because the model is different now, we will create the new predictions. We will check a new confusion matrix, and as we can see, our model has improved. So we would like to see the report, and now everything is just perfect. So that's all for this video. Thank you very much for your attention, and I see you in the next step in the next video. Thank you very much.